I'm Angela Bishop and welcome to Bish's Biz. One thing the Australian music industry does very well is look after a mate when times are tough. The mate in question right now is Angels lead singer Doc Neeson, who was diagnosed with brain cancer on Christmas Eve. 65 of our best artists promptly signed on for a fundraising gig at Sydney's Enmore Theatre that featured everything from a mini Midnight Oil reunion to the Hoff. And the best bit? Doc was there to see it. It's no secret that when tough times hit, the Australian music industry looks out for its own. 65 of our finest artists are putting on a show for the legendary lead singer of the Angels, Doc Neeson.
Emotionally, this is really good for him.
Yeah, and for us too. You know, I think it's good for the industry again to rally and feel strong and connected.
You know, I saw the Angels in 78 going into 1979 when I was a kid, and, you know, they sort of gave me the energy. You know, I wanted to be that energetic when as a performer, as doctors, you know. And we, you know, Noiseworks, when we first started out, the Angels, we supported them all around the country. So everyone knows each other. So it's really just a show of support from, you know, the musical fraternity, and that's the right thing to do.
Backstage, it was like a rock and roll reunion. Bands who've been on the road together for decades, catching up with each other and with Doc, who, despite undergoing aggressive cancer treatment, wasn't going to miss tonight for anything.
The doctors told me probably I wouldn't make it till be, you know, in shape for today, but I'm here to prove them wrong. The Hoff coming along is a really interesting bonus.
That's great.
I'm not quite sure what to make of where that one will go.
Isn't that bizarre?
He's brought his bathers.
These are good guys, you know, and all these guys are here for a reason. And my God, the Angels are just huge out here.
The 66-year-old surprised and delighted some lucky fans who'd come to see the show before getting a few surprises of his own, including getting to see the Federal Education Minister back on stage and back to his musical room. That's what it did feel like out there, Pete?
It felt like it was a great sounding rock band, Ange, and obviously everybody getting together to do this for Doc, but just lots of musos, including my brothers here. Yeah, really a very, very fine sounding night, and especially good thing to see so many people in here.
Does it feel just like it always has when you three get together on stage?
Oh, look, you know, there's no doubt that there is, it's that thing that we had for such a long time. It's still there, there's no question about that. But I think tonight as well, it's really a music community, you know, that really comes together on these sorts of occasions. And, you know, we had other players on stage and the band sounded great, you know, which was nice for me. But I think more importantly, just to, you know, get the people in here and really say that we want to support someone who's going through a tough time, and that made it very special.
It's great Peter could manage that.
Jim, what was it like out there? That was a really nice atmosphere.
Oh, it was great playing for a great crowd and great doing something for the Doc, and the best way to do something for people like that is to just play the music and people just appreciate it. So it was like 30 seconds of joy and everything, and great playing with Don Walker and Rob and Pete and everybody, and it was great fun. So yeah, it's lovely when these things are terrible when they happen, but it is a great way of bringing everyone together.
What's the expression? We all played in different bands together. Is the actual sort of, we all did the same tour and we all went through the same highs and lows, and we all, so we know what it's like.
Look, this, you know, it's a tight community, and you know, people rally in that situation.
I've got to say to everybody, thank you very much for your support, and I'm overwhelmed with it. I really don't know what to say or do with it, you know. And somebody sent me a sample of good luck messages a little while ago. It was just, I think it was about 3,000, you know, signatures sent in then, and then there was another stack. So it's been fantastic. And then I got told that this event was on, which I hadn't expected, and you know, it's not often you get to go to your own wake.
Oh, it's not like that. I knew you were going to make a joke like that. That's not what it is. It's just a bunch of people who want to tell you how much they love you and how much they respect what you do.
Well, it's great. You know, one of the things about this particular gathering is that it's that I'm excited about is that it's kind of a a reunion of some of the bands and the artists who made what you know writers and historians have called the golden era of Australian rock. And to be on stage with them all at once is really exciting.
Did the Oils and the Angels cross paths on the road a lot?
Yeah, no, look, it's interesting. I think particularly in the late 70s and early 80s, particularly when the Sydney pub scene and Melbourne pub scenes were really driving, they were a very, very powerful band, and I used to come and sit beside a stage and watch him do his thing, and he was an incredibly good front man, and he made a very good fist of it.
It's a little unfortunate that, you know, that we all wait till somebody's, you know, sick before we let them know how much we love them, you know? So this is letting Doug know how much we love him.
We had to say, we both were there to say goodbye to Chris last yes. Thursday, Chris Bailey, which was a
sad.
Touching night. So there will be a bit of emotion in the room tonight, won't
there? Yeah, there will be. There will be.
Angela Bishop, 10 News. That's all for now. See you next time.